Hello guys, in this video I'm going to show you how you can set up an FTP server on your Windows 10 operating system. So let's get started. First of all, we need to create a folder. You can create this folder anywhere where you want and name it anything whatever you want. So I'm going to name it as FTP, for example. Okay, and press enter. So this folder we are going to use as a FTP source folder. Okay, now the next step is to open the control panel. So you can open the control panel by right clicking on your start button. So just right click on your Windows 10 start button and then you can just select control panel. Okay, or you can search in here for the control panel and you will be able to find the control panel. Now, once this control panel is open, just select the small icons here and then choose the option which says programs and features. Okay, so just click programs and features, and then in programs and features, just click this option which says turn Windows feature on or off. Okay, so just choose this option and it's going to take a little while and then it's going to open this kind of interface. Now in here we need to search for IIS or Internet Information Services checkbox. So this is the checkbox for Internet Information Services. Just expand that checkbox and first of all check this checkbox first of all, and then once again expand this checkbox and check all the options which you can find in this under this FTP information services. Okay, and you can even check these options, but these are not really important right now. The important thing is these two options must be checked, and this option must be checked, and this option must be checked. Once this option is checked, then you can click OK and it's going to enable and install this IIS services on your Windows 10 operating system in few seconds. So once you see this message which says Windows completed the requested changes, you can close this window and then once again go to the control panel home. So I'm going to just click this option which says control panel home, and this time in here we are going to choose administrative tools. So just click administrative tools and then you will be able to search for Internet Information Services Manager. I'm going to just expand it, and this also. So this option is called Internet Information Services IIS Manager. So just choose this option and double click on it, which is going to open this Internet Information Services Manager. And once this Internet Information Services Manager is open, just expand this here and then expand this sites folder here. Okay, so there is a default website which is by default provided by this IIS manager, and we are going to create a new site here. So just right click on the sites folder and then choose add FTP site. So just choose this option which says add FTP site. And first of all, it will ask you to give any name to your FTP site. I'm going to name it as CodeBind, for example. You can name any thing here. So you can give your own name, right? And then we need to give the physical path. So the physical path will be the folder which you have created for FTP. So this will be my physical path. So I can choose this folder by browsing through this folder. Okay, so go to desktop first of all from here and then choose FTP folder. Okay, so this location is for this folder, and then click next, and in here you need to give the IP address of your computer. So how you can find the IP address of your PC? In start menu, so right click on your start menu and then you will be able to see this command prompt option. So just open the command prompt. Okay, so right click and just open the command prompt by clicking this option. And in here, you need to give this command, which is called ifconfig or ipconfig. Okay, so ipconfig, and then press enter, which is going to give you the IP address of your PC, which is this one, IPv4 address. And you also have the, you know, default gateway address. So the address which we want here is this one, which is 192.168.245.138 in my case. Okay, so just copy this address and then paste it here. Okay, so once you paste this address, then what we need to do is, generally in the production environment, you must use the required SSL option here, but for our purpose we are going to choose this no SSL, right? And then click next, and in here in the authentication we are going to choose the basic authentication, and then in here allow access to, we will just choose the specific user, and then here we will write the username for your computer. So just left click on your just start button once again, and then this is your username at the top. Okay, so whatever username is there, you just need to write it in here in this option. So just left click here and then just copy this username, and in my case it's code bind, so I'm going to just write code bind here, and then the permission, read and write permission. Okay, and then click finish, which is going to add this website to your sites option. Now in the next step, we are going to change the firewall properties of our system. So once again, go to the control panel, and I'm going to choose the small icons once again, and this time we will go to the firewall settings. So just choose this option which says Windows Firewall. Okay, so just choose Windows Firewall, and in the Windows Firewall just choose the first option which says allow an app or feature through Windows Firewall, and once this is open, we are going to change the FTP properties. So in here just search for FTP properties. So before this, we need to just click this button which says change settings, and then search for FTP, this one, FTP server, and then just choose private and public here. Okay, so check here and then check on the public. So it's going to enable both the private and public options, and then click OK. And for the first time, I will also recommend you disable your firewall, and then once everything works properly, then you can re-enable your firewall settings or turn on your firewall. Okay, so I'm going to turn off this firewall. So just go to this option which says turn Windows Firewall on or off, and then I'm going to turn off both the option and then click OK. So firewall options are off, and then this setting is done. Now we need to create an extra account for the FTP user. So just go to the start button once again. So just click here on the start button and then choose this option which says settings, and in the settings you will be able to find the option called your account or accounts option, which is this option. Just click this accounts option, and then it will allow you to create a new account for your computer. So in accounts, you just need to go to family and other users, and in the other users just choose this option which says add someone else to this PC, and this is going to give you this kind of window, and in here we will choose I don't have this person's sign in information, so we don't want to give any email or phone here, and then it's going to allow us to enter the other information for this user. So in this step, we need to choose add a user without Microsoft account. So just choose this option, and in here we can give any name to our new user. For example, I can give the name FTP and then user, FTP minus user. Okay, and then give the password. It's not necessary, but I recommend you give a secure password here, and then the password hint. So you can give any hint to the password. Okay, and then click next, and then this user is added to your PC. Now once this is done, you can close this window, and then you can once again go to this IIS manager window, which is Internet Information Services manager window, and in here we have created this website. So just select this website which you have created, and then just choose the option which says FTP authentication rules. I think this option which says FTP authentication rules, just double click on it, and here you will be able to see your site name and the username of your computer, and in here we are going to add the new user we have created, right? So right click and then click add allow rule, and then here select a specific user, and then once again read and write permission, and in here you just need to give the, you know, username which you have provided for the new user, which is FTP user, right? So FTP minus user in my case, but whatever username you have provided in your case, you need to give that username here. Okay, and once this is done, you can click OK here. So we are done with this FTP authentication rule, so we can close this, and we can close other windows also. Now because we have created this FTP folder using our CodeBind or this main account which we have here, we need to allow the other account which we have created, a new account, we need to allow the access of this folder from that account also. So we need to change the property of this folder also for that. So right click on this folder and then go to the properties. And once this property folder is open, go to security, and then in the security you can just click edit, and in the edit just click add, and in here just give the username of the new user, so FTP and then minus user in my case, and then you can check the name like this. So it's going to give you the full username here. Okay, so just click this check name after writing your username, and it's going to convert this username to this kind of URL, and then click OK. And once this is done, you can just select this user, new user, and then just check this option which says full control. Okay, so just give the full control to this user and then apply, and then click OK, and then click OK. So once everything is done, you can just open your favorite browser, and here you can just write FTP colon forward slash and the IP address of your computer which you have noted using this IP config option, right? So in the terminal, when you have given IP config options, you got this IP address, this IPv4 address. So just copy that same address which you have you know, got from this IP config option, and then paste it here. Okay, so this address will be your this address. Okay, and then press enter, and then it's going to ask for your authentication. Just give the name of your new username, which is FTP user in my case, and then the root password or whatever password you have given. And once you do this, you can just click OK, and it's going to open your FTP server. So in some seconds, we can see this FTP server is opened by the browser. Now let's create some files inside this folder, and let's see what happens. So I'm going to create a folder for example, and I'm going to just name it as test folder, and I'm also going to create a text file here. So test file, and then I'm going to refresh my server once again. So let me just drag this here, and then I will refresh this, and now I can see both the text file and the folder I can see here, and I can see the same last date modified here and here also. So in this way you can set up an FTP server on your Windows 10 operating system. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and bye for now.